Many of you may already be up this morning getting a head start on the Thanksgiving feast, or maybe you stayed up real late, prepping all that good food and have not even gone to bed yet. Well, something Sunny knows a little bit about.
That's right. I do like a feast, and I did prepare my stuff for today.
Thank you.
For when I get home. I love to cook, so this morning I'm going to show you how my family celebrates Thanksgiving Puerto Rican style, or we say Boricua, in our special holiday edition of Insomniac Kitchen. Of course, no Puerto Rican holiday meal would be complete without having plantains. So there is the green plantain, which is, when it's cooked, it's called tostones. They're not sweet, they're sort of a salty, crispy taste. And then there is the maduro, which is the yellow banana. It's basically this banana, but more ripe. And it's very, very sweet. Now, I always have a lot of helpers. Susie's has helped us basically raise our children, but she's now part of our family. And my mother, the judgmental one, this is the tostones. Cut them sideways, and you slant them when you cut them. And then you soak them in cold water and salt, because that—
They won't turn brown.
They don't turn brown. You're gonna cook it and fry it in oil. The oil has to be very, very hot. We're gonna put it on like a medium high, so it's hot enough. Yeah, the sizzling is very important. Susie says they're ready. My mother says they're ready. So we're gonna take it out. You know, you have this sort of strainer. So now we're putting in the tostones to smash it, basically, to press it. Open it up, and this is perfection. That's what it's supposed to look like. And you do that with each and every one. And then we're gonna fry it again. It really makes it perfect. We usually eat it with a sauce of garlic and olive oil and salt, and you kind of dip it in. It's so delicious. So you have fresh garlic, about a spoonful. You have also the olive oil. She's done about three teaspoons, and vinegar, 4 teaspoons of vinegar. You also need a little bit of salt for the mojo. I use kosher salt at home, about a half a teaspoon. Once they're smashed and pressed, we put it back into the oil, so it's double fried. And that's for taste, of course. I mean, you can't worry about the calories around the holidays. For the second time frying it, after you've pressed them, maybe 1 to 2 minutes frying it. You don't want to overcook it, but you want it to sort of look golden brown. And what I usually do when I take them out, I usually put a napkin on the plate so that the oil is drained. Oh, my mother is proclaiming them beautiful. Look at that. And sometimes, so you have it with the little mojo. Sometimes you can also sprinkle it with a little bit of kosher salt. Am I right, Mom?
Yes.
Yeah.
According to your personal taste.
And that's, you see, Susie dipped it in the mojo. So very delicious. No, really, they're perfect.
They're perfect.
They're perfect. They're perfect.
So nice you fried it twice. That's what I'm talking about.
That's the thing. It's not for the health conscious, right? Because
no.
You fry it twice and put more salt on it. But I got to tell you, I could taste it right now. They are so good. And I was going to bring some for you.
But
my mother said they don't travel well because it is sort of like a French fry. I mean, you can't heat it up. And
you fry, you got to eat right away.
You
can't reheat it. It's never the same.
No, but I'm gonna get you some.
I appreciate that.
Somehow.
Those things look good. You've been cooking good for us the last 2 days.
So good.
Oh, man. And if you like that, buddy, we got more coming.
Yes, I'm back in the kitchen with my Puerto Rican eggnog coquito when we come back. You're watching World News Now.
Yes, indeed.
No Puerto Rican holiday can pass without having coquito. So I'm gonna show you how to make that Puerto Rican eggnog. Usually just 1 can of cream of coconut. 1 can of sweetened condensed milk. Evaporated milk also. Also put in vanilla. This is really great vanilla from Mexico. This may make it a bit different than your typical eggnog. We put about 1.5 cups of rum in it. White rum. Some people use dark rum. I'm gonna put a little bit of cognac in there. Not even half of a cup, like a third, just for flavor. And you mix it on low. Some people do it by hand. You have just a little tiny bit of cinnamon. Go. Salud. Happy holidays.
I love my job.
This is coquito, and this is actually a traditional Puerto Rican cup. It's a tin cup, and you drink it in the tin cup because it makes it very cold if you put ice cubes in it.
It is so weird. We put a few cubes in there before we came back,
yes.
And
they're very, very cold, right?
It's kind of like a Brandy Alexander, kind of
sort
like.
Sort of. I mean, it does have the three types of liqueur.
It's the cognac, the rum,
and the brandy.
Look, these are
salud.
A few of
and you
my
have to say
favorite things. Yes, indeed.